Yes, so guys, we're back. We want to continue still in matrix. We want to look at the determinant of a matrix. Now, it is becoming tougher somehow. So let's look at the determinant. The determinant of a matrix, it's, we want to start with the 2x2 first. So let's say we have a matrix that has two rows and two columns. So the determinant is given by the A, which is the same as determinant A. For this matrix is given as A, B, C, D. So in a question where they say solve, and you see these vertical lines, it means find the determinant. And the procedure for the determinant is, I'll just give you a small code here. It is plus, this is plus arrow down, minus arrow up. This is plus arrow down, minus arrow. What do I mean by that? I multiply those diagonals. This is times D minus C times B. So it's going to be AD minus BC. That is the determinant of this. It's the determinant of the A. It's given by that. Yeah. So let's say, for instance, if I have example, I have a matrix of 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now I want to find the determinant of A. So determinant A, which is given by A, is given by, I can go like this. This is 2 times 5, that is 2 times 5, minus, this is 4 times 4 times 3. So this is 10 minus 12. So the determinant is minus 2. So for a 2x2 matrix, the determinant is you multiply this leading diagonal minus, you multiply the other diagonal there, and that is the determinant. What about a 3x3 matrix? If it's a 3x3 matrix, we want to write the determinant A is given as here. This is A, B, C, then D, E, F, then G, H, I. Now, for as much as I want to find the determinant here, I first look for the place signs or the sign place. The sign place is based upon this logic here, if you want to. It's going to be plus, minus, plus. They have minus, plus, minus. They have plus, minus. They have plus. So watch, this is the sign place of all the elements in there. So it means that if I want to find the determinant of a 3x3, I'm going to take the first element and find the minor of that element. So it means if I take A, this is going to be equals to, in this case, this is A. I take this first guy here. A is plus, so it's A plus A. That is plus, because the sign for that guy is 4, is plus. So when I crease this, across this, I'm left with this 4. So it's good. I'm left with that 4. So I take the 4 out. This is E, F, H, and I. Yeah. When I'm finding the minor of this, so I'll cancel each row and cancel each column. So I'm left with this 4. This 4. Those are the ones there. So I use them to find the determinant. So that is A plus A. Then into, this is EI, this E times I, then minus HF. Alright, so I'm done with that. Then I come back. I want to find the determinant, this minor of this B. So the minor of B is on that. Then I remove this here. I'm left with this and this, this and this. So we have for B, it is D F G, I. So, and the B has its place sign as minus, so it's minus B into, then I cross multiply them. This is, I find the determinant of this, minus GF. So I'm done with that. I come back for C. For C, I remove this. So C is T on this row, but it is now on this column. So now I take this, 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 and this. So let's say, so I have D, E, G, and H there. So, and the place value, the place sign of C is that. So I have plus C into, then I have D, H, D, H, minus G, E. Yeah. So when I add all of them, that is what gives me the determinant of this. The answer of this plus the answer of this plus the answer of this give me the determinant of the whole 3 by 3. So watch out the technique here. You have to first of all master the place sign. The place sign is the negative there, negative, negative, negative. You master the place sign. This is a plus. So this is for this. And so if I was to put the place sign, I have minus, I have plus here, then I have minus, then I have plus. So that's the meaning of the place signs here. There's a good, this element also has this sign. This one has this sign, this one has this sign. So you have to master the place sign before you use the determinant method to find the 3 by 3 by using the determinant. Now we'll take a few examples on this one there. So let's say, for instance, I have a question like this. Say, find the determinant of the following. So you can just pause there whilst I write the question. So we try to, I want to stop here so that, I want to write the question. All right, guys, welcome back. We want to look at the past questions now on determinant. Look at 2017, that is November, it's a private exam. Now it says, I told you that when you have these vertical lines, it tells you that the determinant is what you're supposed to find. So we know that determinant is, I wrote down, remember that, I said 3 times 5 minus into 4 times minus x. All must be equals to minus 10. According to this question, remember the determinant procedure. I multiply this one, and it's equals to this according to this question. So I have 15 minus into minus 4x is equals to minus 10. Now this 4 times minus x is minus 4x. So I clear the bracket here. I have 15 plus 4x is equals to minus 10. Yep, so we have 4x is equals to minus 10, then I cross over, this is minus 15. So 4x is going to be equals to, this is minus 25. This is minus 25, so I divide here by 4, divide here by 4. So x is equals to minus 25 all over 4. Alright, so that has the value of x from that point. So you can use this technique to also find the, let's say, determinant number 2. This is if A is equals to, let's say you have 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, minus 1, 1, and 3, and 2 again here. Now you ask to find the determinant of A here. This is 3 by 3. Remember what I told you? I said that you take the minor of this, so this equals to, I take that 2, that's the minor of this guy. Is I take the minor of this. If I take these two, I'm left with 0 times 2, and 0 times 2, and minus 3 into minus 1. That is, this multiply that. Then I come with the minus 3, that's a minus. Remember the place sign? Remember the place sign was plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, in that order. So this is a plus there. And this one is a minus somewhere there. So I take this. If I cancel this row and this column, I'm left with this and this. So it is 5 times 2. Then I take this, multiply by this, minus 1 times minus 1. Yep. So I come back, plus, I take this other 1, that is 4, into. And if I take this row and this column out, I'm left with this. This is 5 times 3 minus 1 times 0. Minus 1 times 0. Yeah. So now you have seen that I found the minor of all of them. So I took this here. Then if I cross this 2, I'm left with this 4 set. Those are the ones I found the determinant of. That is 0 times that and this times that. That's how I got it. So we have 2 into, this is 0, this is plus 3. Then I have minus 3 into, this is 10, this is plus 1. Is minus 1 times minus 1 is plus 1. This is 10 over there. So we'll have that. Then plus 4 into, this is 15. This is 15 minus 0. Minus 1 times 0 is 0. So we'll have, this is 2 into 3. Then minus 3 into 11. Then plus into 15. Plus 4 into 15. This is 4 into 15. 15 minus 0 is that. So this is therefore equals to, this is 6. this is minus 33, this is minus 33, then you have plus, this is 4, that's 60. So you now have, this is minus 27 in that case. So 6 minus that, minus 27, then 60. So you must be able to look at the two, that now we have, this is 60 minus, this is 33, this is 33 in that order. So you now have the determinant of this as 33. So now we have got the 3x3 matrix and we've got the answer as 33. But I want to give you another short form of this. I designed a rule for it. I call it the Quadius rule, if you like. This is Quadius rule, the Quadius rule. Now from the Quadius rule, you copy, let's copy the first, let me write the matrix again. So in the Quadius version, you have the matrix. The matrix itself is 2, 3, 4, and 5, 0, minus 1. Then you have 1, 3, 2. Now under the Quadius rule, you will copy the first two columns. So let me copy the first two columns. 5 is 1. Then you have 3, 0, and 3 again. So I have copied the first two columns and added it to the existing column. So that is what is meant by the copy and add on the existing. So I now have 5. So the next stage is to identify leading diagonal. So I have a leading diagonal there, a leading diagonal somewhere there. I have a leading diagonal somewhere there. So 3 of them there. And I also have another 3 down here. This is another 3 down here, another 3 down there. So that is the second stage, that is to identify the first, you copy the first two columns and add to the existing one. That's what I've done. I copied this and I place it at the back because I'm having 5 columns right now. So I have to multiply along the diagonal. So it is 1 times 0 times anything multiplied by 0 is 0, and the end is always to multiply by a negative. So I continue. This is 3 times minus 1 is minus 3 times this is minus 6. So minus 6 multiply minus 6 multiply by a negative. There's a negative always at the end. So I now have let me just write it in the form that it's readable. So it's minus to minus 6. Remember, there's a minus at the end of this line. You always end up multiplying the whole term there by a minus. So minus minus will give me a 6 plus. So now this is 2 times 5 is 10. 10 times 3 is 30. 30 times that minus is minus 30. So now I'm adding them. So summation up. This is adding all of them is 0 plus 6 minus 30. Yes, so now this will give me summation up. That is the summation of all these ones up is minus 24. So that's one. So I come back to the one under. When I'm resulting here, the end is always plus. On the top there is minus. Now the bottom here is always plus. So I go 4 times 5 is 20. 20 times that is 60. 60 times plus is 60. Plus 60, of course. So I come back here. 3 times minus 1 is minus 3. Times 1 is minus 3. Times that plus is T minus 3. Yeah. So I go, this is here, 0, 0 times anything is 0, so it's 0. So if I can have summation up, this is summation down here is, this is 0 plus, let's just put the number straight, 0 minus 3 plus 60. So you find out that this one is going to give you somewhere around 57. This is 57, positive number, 57, larger number carries the sign. So under the Quadius rule, after doing that, you will now come and add. So the matrix, the determinant is now equals to summation up plus summation down. So what was the summation up? Summation up was minus 24, and summation down was 57. So if you add the two, you now find out that you have 33, which is the same as this. So now I'll just go over it again for your comprehension. After replacing or copying the first two and place at the back, you multiply along the diagonal. When you're multiplying up, the summation of up is always multiplied by a negative number. negative by negative. You multiply all these terms. When you, the answer of this line multiplied by negative, answer of this line multiplied by negative, answer of this line multiplied by negative, that's meaning by that. Now summation down is also the answers of all of this multiplied by a plus. This is plus. You can see here, this is 3 times minus 1 minus multiplied by 1 is going to be minus 3. Minus 3 times plus, this is a positive here. Minus 3 times plus is minus 3 still. So here it is 4 times 5, 20. 20 times 3 is 60. 60 times plus, that plus times that 60 is T plus. So that 60 remains as it is. So when you're done, you add the total here. Total of this up and total of this down, you put them together, gives you the same answer. That's what's called the Quadratic rule. If you like, you can use all of that and it will help you out as you proceed in your exams. All right, it's all accepted. So now let's proceed to